Dear friends, in this video I will be talking about signal transformation. Actually, it is not the transformation of the amplitude of the signal, but it is the transformation of independent variable of the signal. So independent variable, if it is replaced or it is changed, suppose t is the independent variable, so t is shifted, or it is t is replaced by t minus t naught, so there is a transformation in the signal. So likewise, there is another transformation, replace t by ct, where c may be less than 1 or greater than 1, what happens to signal? And if we replace t by minus t, what happens to signal? So all these are the transformations on the independent variables of the signal. So these transformations are translation transformation, rotation transformation, scaling transformation. We will be studying all these three transformations, and after that we'll see whether these transformations are really they commute or not, or if I change their sequence, what happens to signal, or when, in which situation we can change the translation or rotation or scaling or scaling or rotation, or in which situation they will not be changed, or is it this rotation and scaling, are they commutative? Whether translation and rotation, they are not commutative, and again translation and scaling, they are not commutative. All those things we'll see with the help of proofs. So let us start with translation operation. Translation is a transformation which we can perform on the independent variable of the signal. So the first operation, whatever I was telling, is translation. Translation is related to shifting of signal either towards left or towards right. It is related to shift of a signal. So if x of t is a signal which we are having, and I am doing some transformation on this, and I am getting x of t minus t naught. So what we can say is, here signal x of t, if t naught is positive, signal x of t is shifted by t naught towards right. So it is a shifting of signal towards right. If I say x of t plus t naught, the signal is shifted towards left as long as t naught is positive. So, and entire signal is shifting, right? The entire signal is shifting, not that instant is shifting. So many times, to avoid all that, what we do, entire signal is denoted by dot. X dot means entire signal, and if I say transformation is applied, so it is x dot, entire signal is shifted by t naught. So x of t minus t naught, it means entire signal x of t is shifted by t naught. So you can say like this also, you can write like this also, t is operating on x of dot, and transformation is, let us say it is delay or advanced transformation, I am using, let us say d for that. So it is x of dot minus t naught. Dot minus t naught is signal is shifted by t naught. You can put at particular instant if you want to find. So put here particular instant x of t. So here x of t minus t naught. X of r. So here x of r minus r naught, or x of r minus t naught. So it is called translation. Translation of the signal towards right or left. So this operation, what it does, it accept the signal, and it, what it does, when I say delay, it is going to shift entire signal towards right, and when I say advance, okay, that time delay by td, suppose if I am saying td is for delay by t naught. Td is a transformation which is delaying signal x of the x dot. X dot means entire signal. Entire signal is shifted by t naught. So this is td is a transformation which can be used for delaying or advancing the signal. So again, x dot, if I say x dot is going undergoing other under translation, that is, you can use again td. but here meaning is signal is advance by T0. So here x of dot plus T0. So signal is shifted. Signal is shifted towards left by T0. So this is, we can say, advancing the signal, and minus sign, that is delaying the signal. So translation is operation which is used for shifting the signal either towards right or left. So it is a signal, we are passing it through a system. We can say that it is a system passing through a system which is either delay system or which is advancing system. So if it is a delay system, it is going to shift the signal towards right, and if it is an advanced system, it is going to shift signal towards left. Okay, so after studying this translation, we will go to second transformation, which is on the independent variable of the signal. I am not playing with the amplitude of the signal, I am playing with the independent variable of the signal. So again, I am going for rotation. Rotation is another kind of transformation which we can perform on the signal, whatever signal, continuous time signal, it is there, as well as in discrete case also there. I am taking here example of continuous time signal. So what I am doing, x dot is a signal. Okay, I am performing rotation transformation. Let us say TR is a rotation transformation. What I get is whatever is my, okay, in particular, let us say dot means entire signal is rotated about origin. So suppose we are having like this signal, given signal is like this. Okay, so this is my x of t, and on this x of t, I am performing this TR. So what I am getting is the triangle is going towards what? It is going towards left side, and here this rectangle is coming towards right side. So this translation, what it is doing? It is rotating the signal around origin, right? This is x of minus t, or we can say it is x minus dot, and here x dot, right? So dot, you understood now, dot means entire signal, and when I put something for the dot, it becomes at that particular instant. So entire signal is rotated about the origin, that is called mirroring of the signal. Mind well, I am doing transformation on independent variable of the signal, argument of the signal, not on the amplitude of the signal. So this is rotation operation, rotation of given signal with respect to origin. So this is second operation. The first was translation, second is rotation, and one more operation is there, that is called as scaling. Third operation which we can perform on signal is scaling. And by combining this translation, rotation and scaling, we can do every kind of operation on the given signal. Now let us go to third operation or third transformation, which is again on the independent variable, rotation. So rotation we have seen, scaling. Rotation is, I have explained you, t is replaced by minus t, that time it becomes a rotation kind of operation, or it is mirroring of the signal. Now let us see third operation, which is scaling. If we scale the independent variable, what happens to signal? That is scaling operation. So here what I am doing is, I am having for scaling, let us say TS, I am denoting an operator TS as a scaling operator, operating on x dot entire signal. And what is happening here is, you are getting some signal which is some constant time, this independent variable. Okay, in particular at t equal at dot equal to t, so you can get x of c into t, xct is equal to x of t, because of this ts becoming x of ct, x of ct, or we can write like this, x of x dot, it is passing through a system, right, denoted by ts, and what is that you are getting in x of c dot. If c is greater than 1, c is what, greater than 1, let us say c equal to 2, so it is, and dot equal to 2, or dot equal to t, so x of 2t, x of 2t, in that case what is happening, x of t and x of 2t, if you plot, so x of 2t is compression, we get compressed signal at the output. Suppose I am having signal here from minus 1 to plus 1 and c is 2, c is 2, in that case what happens, my signal will be from minus half to plus half, signal is compressed by factor of 2, okay, so if c is greater than 1 and c equal to 2, in that case we can get like that. If c is less than 1, in that case there is a expansion of signal along time axis, signal gets stretched. If c is 1/2, so signal becomes exactly 2 times of the original signal. Suppose original signal is from minus 1 to plus 1, but if I take c equal to 1/2, what happens, the signal is stretched by 2, so minus 1 goes to minus 2 and plus 1 goes to plus 2, this is called stretching of signal, signal gets stretched. So this scaling is used for either for stretching or by compression of the signal. So by using this scaling, rotation, translation, you can perform all kind of operations on the independent variable, Now let us see whether these operations are commutative or not. It means if I change the order of the operation, whether result will be same or not, that is what I want to explain you. Let us consider this scaling and rotation, whether they are commuting or not. If I change their order, result will be different or result will be same, that is what I am going to explain you. So let us take first TR means, you know, it is a rotation operation, TR, and after that take scaling, it is either compression or expansion. If that C is greater than 1, it is compression, C is less than 1, it is expansion. And TR means rotation of the signal about origin, means mirror image of the signal. So here, this is one, here I am taking particular instant for the understanding purpose, let us say x of t, and here in between output, let us say w of t. So here understanding dot I have removed, but understanding should be that when whatever we are performing, it is performing on the entire signal. So if I try to write wt, wt will be what? Wt will be x of t going through TR. TR means rotation. So rotation means x of minus t. And wt is passing through this scaling system. So what is y1 of t? y1 of t is w of c into t. So scaling by c, we don't know what is c, may be less than 1 or c may be greater than 1. So now we know y1, which is in terms of w, but we want y1 in terms of x of t. So w of ct, what will be w of ct? T will be replaced by ct. W of t is x of minus t, w of ct is what? X of minus ct. So x of minus ct, here when I perform first rotation, or we can say it is reflection is a proper word than the rotation. If I reflecting the signal about origin, then I am scaling, right? So reflection and scaling, these are the two operations. Instead of rotation, I am using proper word reflection, and here it is scaling. So then now if I change the order, what happens? So here I am taking first scaling and then I am taking reflection TR, right? So here x of t, let us say here p of t, let us see here y2 of t. If y1 of t and y2 of t, if they are same, I can say that scaling and reflection, these two transformation, they commute. So whenever these two operations to be performed on the signal, order of the operation is not important. Order of the operation is not important. You perform first scaling and then rotation, or first rotation and then scaling. So again, I am saying rotation and reflection. Reflection is a proper word for the rotation. So here P of T, now it is T of S. S is for scaling. So X of C into T. C is a scaling parameter. Let us assume that. So Y to T. So Y2 of T. So here P of minus T. We know that P of T is X of CT. T is replaced by minus T. What happens? T is replaced by minus T. So it will be X of minus C dot T. It is minus X of C dot T. Y2 and Y1. So what is the value of Y1? Y1 is X of minus C into T. Here also X of minus C into T. What does this implies? Y1 equal to Y2. Y1 equal to Y2 means rotation and scaling, these are the two operations, they commute, right? Reflection and scaling do commute. Okay, so what is the meaning which we have got through this? Reflection and scaling commute. They commute, right? They commute means what? Order can be changed, the result will be same. In what order we are performing these two operations, that order is not important. At the end, final result will be same. So either you perform reflection and scaling, or you perform scaling and reflection, output is same. Now let us see what happens to translation and scaling. Okay, so we'll see translation and scaling, whether they commute or not. Now we'll see what happens to translation and scaling. So let us find out. So translation, I am using TD. So it can be delay or it can be advance. I am using transformation or I am using operator TD. And here I am using operator TS, scaling by C. Okay, it is scaling by C. And here delay by T naught. Okay, either you can assume delay or you can assume advance. So I am using delay. And here again X of T means entire signal. I am not using dot just to avoid confusion. Here Y1 of T and here intermediate output. Let us again take W of T. Now here what I am doing is I am writing Y1 of T. What is Y1 of T? Y1 of T is nothing but we are passing WT through a system which is a scaling system and which is scaling by C. So WCT will be the output. WCT is the output. Now what I am doing is I am finding what is the value of WT. WT is nothing but X of T minus T naught, right? Because X of T is delay by T naught. So WT is X of T minus T naught. I want WCT because output Y1 of T is W of CT. So W of T, T is replaced by 1, it is 1 minus T naught. T is replaced by 2, 2 minus T naught. T is replaced by CT, so it will be X of CT. T is replaced by CT, T naught, there is no change. CT minus T naught. So this is the result when we first take translation and then take scaling. Now if you reverse the order, what will be the output? That is the question. So reverse the order. So let us make it TS, make it TD, and let us have this is Y2. okay, and we have result y1. What is y1? y1 is this we are having. Now let us find y2t. y2t is wt is shifted by t0. wt, I am taking intermediate output wt, which is applied to td and which is w of t minus t0. So what is wt? wt is the output of first system. What is that? X of t is scale x of c into t, right? X of c into scaling by c, scaling by parameter c. C is some constant, right? So now what I want? I want wt minus t0. Wherever t is there, I will be replacing t by t minus t0. So what happens? T is replaced. So c is there, t is replaced by t minus t0, right? I want to find value of wt minus t minus t0. So t is replaced by t minus t0. C is multiplier for t and t is replaced by t minus t0. So output will be x of ct minus ct0. So this is your y2 and this is your y1, and y1 of t is not equal to y2 of t. So be careful whenever you are using translation and scaling operations. They do not commute. Translation and scaling, they do not commute. Order is very important. In which order you are applying these operations, that is very important. If you interchange the order, result will be different. See here, y1, it is x of ct minus t0. Here it is x of c into t minus c into t0. The scaling parameter is there with both the, there at both the places. Here c parameter is there with the only t, not with t0. So this is reflect, this is what translation and scaling. Let us see what happens if I take translation and reflection, translation and reflection, whether they commute or not. So whenever translation comes, be careful while interchanging the operation. That is the message which I would like to give to you. So here I am talking about reflection, and this is your y1 of t, and here again I am taking intermediate output w of t. So td is a system which is delaying the output by t0, and tr is a system which is taking the reflection of the signal, mirroring of the signal, which is doing mirror, which is giving me mirror image of the signal. So y1 of t, if I am talking about y1 of t, which is giving me w of minus t. W of minus t means folding of a signal around origin. So this is a reflection operation, okay, rotation operation around the origin. And what is td? Td is delaying. So wt is delayed version of x of t, x of t minus t0, because this is a system which is delaying this signal and we are getting wt. Wt is delayed version of input. This is input, okay, this is output. So now we have to write y1 of t. Our objective is write y1 of t in terms of input. y1 of t is not available in terms of input, it is available in terms of w. So what is w? W is this. What is w of minus t? W of minus t, wherever t is there, replace t by minus t. So what happens? So what is y1 of t? y1 of t is w of minus t. What is w of minus t? Replace t by minus t. So what happens? X of minus t minus t0. Don't change this sign, because t is changing, so t will change, t0 will not change. So it is your y1 of t. Now let us interchange the system, interchange the order of the system and see what happens. So this is your tr and this is your td. So see what output you get. Again, y2, here it is y2. So y2 of t is equal to w of t minus t0, w of t minus t0, okay. So and what is w of t? W of t is x of minus t. What is w of t minus t0? T is replace t by t minus t0. T is replaced by t minus t0. So what happens? W of t minus t0 wherever t is there, replace that t, minus sign is out. So t minus t naught. So what happens here? It is x of minus t plus t naught. So this is what y2 of t, and here y1 of t and y2 of t both are not matching. So what conclusion we can make here is your translation and scaling and translation and reflection, they do not commute. When your translation operation is coming, be careful, do not change the order with scaling, do not change the order with reflection. So translation operation is whenever it is coming with scaling and reflection, it is not commuting. What is that we have to remember? Scaling and reflection, it is commuting. We can change the order of scaling and reflection, not the scaling and translation, not the reflection and translation. This is what I wanted to show through this video, because these are very important operations: reflection, scaling, translation. If you know these three operations, we can do all kind of operation on the signal by using these three operations. Understanding of these three operations is very important. Okay, when the sign is changing, when sign is becoming plus, when sign is becoming minus, when the system is changing from second to first to second. So the order of the system, how output is changing, just remember this thing. If you remember this thing, you can do every kind of transformation on the given signal with respect to independent variable. Again, I am telling you that this is the transformation on the independent variable, not the transformation on the amplitude of the signal. I am not playing with amplitude, I am playing with independent variable of the signal. So let us stop here. I hope this video is a very important video for you, and if you understand this video, you will understand all kind of transformation with respect to independent variable on the signal.